So I'm on TryHackMe's website and I've gone over to the colddboxeasy room, an easy level machine with multiple ways to escalate privileges. Can you get access and get both flags? Good luck. Bootroot. Let's go start machine. I'm going to need to download my config file, being a new machine and all. So on a Kali, let's go open VPN. And because I'm using WSL, we need to go from the mount directory, and then we can navigate our file explorer file system in Windows. Just pop that in downloads. And there it is. Great. We should see initialization sequence completed. So if we run ifconfig, we should see our TUN 0 now. And that is my TryHackMe IP. And we should refresh and see green. There's our IP. Sweet. So let's get the IP of our remote system and we will ping that. Awesome. Let's just go ahead and make a directory, or let's make two directories rather. And now we can run nmap. I'm going to skip host discovery and let's just do a broad scan for the first time. It looks like out of our top 1000 ports, we only have 80. So we can do a couple of things. We might look at all ports, but let's focus on port 80 and let's just get more information about this. So we're going to look at versions and then I think that's scripts. Okay, so it looks like we're running WordPress, an older version, 4.1.31, running on Apache. So something that I've just realized is I am on the network through this Kali, but if I try and navigate to this IP on my host machine, we're not going to find it. So in PowerShell, let's just search OpenVPN. So our first one, we've got the ID here. So using the Winget package manager, we can go install and we can right click our OpenVPN, import from the file, and I can open up the config. We are connected. I can see my TryHackMe. So now on my host system, should be able to ping TryHackMe test server and we're good, which means now if I navigate to our website, we can see it. Awesome. So let's look at our other ports. We're going to look for all ports that are open on this system now. So maybe there's like a different high port or something. So we'll let that run. And let's just manually inspect this system, see what we can find. First thing is we've got our login page and that definitely confirms it's a WordPress site. The Coldbox is here. Welcome to Coldbox, a machine designed by Cold. So just a Twitter link. It is a very simple machine to solve with several ways to escalate privileges, which serves to reinforce concepts. Without further ado, good luck and enjoy. So it looks like this is a post. So we have some comments from Sir Hot. I like the machine. It offends me that it is cold inside. Long life to heat. Sir Hot, I get it. So just a normal form, which does take HTML. So that kind of makes me think maybe might be able to inject some HTML in here, do something funky. Maybe just an idea. So I have noticed that we've got ?p=1. So maybe we can look at different posts here just by trying a few. Not really. The box just is now lagging. Something tells me this scan is I've flooded the box and it's not responding. This is like one downside of nmap, is kind of annoying to use. Let's just look up Rust scan. I'm just gonna quickly install this. Given that this is a new system, I'm just going to install Docker because we're gonna need that. So install using the app repository, which we like, make sure we've updated everything, adding an official GPG key. So let's just quickly follow this. This is good to know, which we are using Kali Linux, and now we can install everything or not. Okay, after a little problem solving, i.e. just reading what the instructions say, I just had to replace this version code name, which was grabbing Kali Linux And I just replace it with Bookworm. So that's what it's said to do. And looks like it's grabbed it now. So last step, should be able to get all of that. Cool. So it looked like it works. And to confirm that it worked, we can run sudo docker run hello world. And we have another error. Okay, so I've had to run Docker D, so I guess it's not running in the background. I guess after a system restart, it'll probably work. So there it is running. So what we're going to do is grab this alias, and in our bash RC file, we can pop it anywhere. I'm just going to throw it down the end. This will run Docker for us and go grab rust scan. So we'll type in rust scan. Yeah, we're gonna have to cancel that. Rust scan dash A for the IP. And we'll just start off with that. That didn't work. Oh, that's right. And we just need to run source once we've updated it. So that gave us an error. So we run sudo. Might try and just put sudo in front of it. Don't know if this is best practices. After a quick restart of WSL, looks like rust scan is working. So yeah, awesome. So rust scan, this is just, it's so much faster. There we go. Got our high port and already know that port 80 is there. Apparently we're supposed to use this. I have seen other people use it, not really tried it, but we do have our two port. So let's find out more information about our two ports. So we'll do a scan on those and we'll just ask for that. And we'll be able to tee that out to a file. Okay, so we've got our ports. We're just going to put them through and only look at them. Just ask for more information and just output that to a file. I want to try that again, but use this. Okay, that didn't work either. So apparently we need to change the batch size. That didn't work either. So apparently we need to put in our timeouts, make that 2000. Let's see how that goes. Okay, that still gave us an error. I think it's just our output file. So let's try the T method instead. Rust one, that kind of just like holds there. So I don't think it likes me teeing this out. And I'm kind of stuck. So let's try this one more time, just without teeing anything. And that worked super fast, like it should. So it looks like SSH is on an unusual port. So this is kind of telling us we just need to focus on this website. That is our way in, and hopefully we get something to then get into that SSH. So we can type try WP scan. So this is our URL that we're going after. Wow, I don't even have man. Okay, I thought that just would have been, you know, I don't know, yeah, by default. So the WordPress security scanner, we want to use the dash E for enumerate, and then pass through some options so we can try and find vulnerable plugins, vulnerable themes, perhaps. So it's a bit of a trial and error. We can start off with just vulnerable plugins, VT for vulnerable themes, dash U for users, I don't know, M for media. Okay, let's see how that looks. I think it's dash dash URL. So while that's running, let's see if there's any directories that we can kind of find. So we're going to be using the fast web fuzzer written in Go. So let's start off with the dash U. So we want to put in our keyword fuzz where we're going to be looking. We want to specify a word list. So in the share directory, we've got word lists. Let's go in the derb and we'll just use the big.txt. We might want to specify some extensions. So the dash E is a comma separated list of extensions to use. So we know that it's running PHP because it's on Apache. So we go .php for PHP files. .txt is a good idea, and we're dealing with HTML, so HTML is a good idea. There's also a dash R to follow redirects, which by default is false. So in case it finds a file or a directory, it'll look inside that directory and keep going. So let's that run and do its thing. So our scan has found a theme, 2015, which is an outdated version of the theme. So perhaps there's some vulnerability there. So our fuzzing has found the hidden directory. Urgent. Cole, you changed Hugo's password. When you can, send it to him so he can continue uploading his articles. So we've just been told three usernames, all in the one nice message. So that's handy. So let's take another stab at our WordPress scan. So there is a passwords flag which can do a password attack. So list of passwords to use during a password attack if no usernames options are supplied. User enumeration will be run. But we do have a username list now, so we can try that. So let's go dash u and we can send through a list. So cold with a 0 and 2 d's, Hugo, and it's kind of hard because usually usernames are like lowercase, so I'm just kind of assuming they're lowercase. And for a password, it's always good to just use your rocku.txt. That's always pretty safe. So we can see the password attack on the WP login against our three users. So it's just cycling through our three users and our password list, which is going to take a little bit of time. It's good time to take a break. Unless we get lucky, the password might be up top, or this doesn't work. What I'm going to confirm while that's running is let's go over to the login page. It's like we found the usernames and we've just kind of assumed the username. But let's actually just, like, if we type in test, you know, invalid username. So we're trying to verify if these are real usernames. So using this cold username, we do get the password you entered for the username cold is incorrect. So it's kind of telling me that this is a user. And we can do that again with Philip. So Philip is a user, but Philip's is not a user, and same with Hugo. So we definitely have the three users there. Cool. So for the sake of time, I'm going to paste in the password that you'll find, and we can indeed log in as our user Colt. Awesome. And now the world is kind of our oyster of how we want to get into this. I'm going to go appearance editor. I think all the scanning has just like actually killed this box. Whoops. So new IP. Who dis? Gonna ping it and it might take a minute or so to get online, but always good to check that I'm definitely still online, which it looks like I'm not. Actually think I know my issue. Actually think that this is still running from when I first ran that. We should be able to put that down. I have config. Yeah, so we shouldn't have ton zero here. We should only have it here on my host system, I think. Yeah, that looks better. I actually think that's why I was having issues. Cool, good to know. So let's go back and log in. So our user cold has this password that we found. So appearance, editor, and now we can edit any of these pages. So, you know, I'm just going to go for the index.php, the first page that loads. So there is actually some web shells built in, not necessarily built in, but just there's copies of them in the user share web shells. So that command will just take us right there. And we're after a PHP. So the PHP reverse shell is a good one. So let's open that up in Nano. And we are just going to put in our details. So this is our IP that we want to connect back to. So mine is 10.4.1.107. And I can just confirm that by looking at our IP. We can run IPA to see our IP. Make sure it's our ton zero network interface. Or we can run classic if config. Well, actually, yeah, that won't show it because that's just the WSL. So that's actually interesting that I can still see that on IPA. Good to know. And then for port, we could, I'm just going to leave it as 1234. We can change it to anything. I'm going to attempt to use xclip, and apparently I can take the selection and copy that with the PHP reverse shell. If that's what I can copy the index.php, which will break this website, and I can paste in our reverse shell, which I've just copied to the clipboard. Just confirm there is definitely our IP is in there. We're starting off with PHP. Don't need all these comments, but that's fine. I'm just going to go update file. So now we just need a netcat listener, and we're just going to make sure it's on the same port as we set in our reverse shell. So what should work is if we go here and we type in index.php, we should see something. So that didn't work. All right, let's get this happening a second time. Maybe I selected the wrong, because we should update this and essentially just break the site. I'm sure that there's like a better way of doing this, or it's possible that it just didn't take. That's also a possibility. I just didn't like it, so we might pick another PHP file because we should get it pretty fast. Yeah, so that's just not working. Let's just try something like, I don't know, the header. Technically, we could just put it like above the header, right? Something like that. Update file. That works. So if we visit the site, that should just run it. Because I mean, this is like the header part of each, I assume, page. So it should just run that reverse shell and we should be good as gold. If that still doesn't work, I think we can replace the functions.php file. So let's try the functions. So this is for 2015. I'm not sure if that's even like, is that the active one? Looks like we've lost connection to the box again. Yeah, it looks like it's just our connection to the network. It's going to run reconnects on our OpenVPN connection on the host system. Okay, not sure what's actually causing that, but there we go. Yeah, it's kind of unusual. Now the second I try and look at the website, just blocks connection. So I think the reverse shell is really killed this box. Yeah, restart box again. Okay, since I'm having troubles, I'm gonna switch over to Metasploit. So let's boot up MSF console and let's search for the WPIN WordPress admin. So our only option is so. So let's use zero and let's look at our options. Let's set our L host to, might set global actually, 10.4.1.107. And let's set global L port to 1234. Then we just need to set the username to cold, and then we're just going to set the password. And once that's all set, we should just be able to go run. Following options failed to validate our hosts. Well, that is because I didn't set one. Now we can go run. It's going to start a reverse TCP handler. It's going to authenticate and it's going to exploit. No access. Failed to authenticate with WordPress. So complete, but no session was created. Is this because I'm using Windows subset for Linux? Let's try and make our connection us. So let's set G L host and now let's try and run. And that's a no-go. Let's actually set L host to ton zero. See if that works. Target does not appear to be using WordPress. I would beg to differ. I am getting like a reoccurring issue and I don't know why. So looking it up, got an example here doing like the 404 page. Maybe that's a better way of doing it. But looking at our example, we need to like go to the exact, I would kind of just imagine that we would type in anything and it would trigger it, but I guess not. So WP content themes, and this is using 2015 404.php, and we'll get that listener back up. Hit enter. Page is hanging, which is a good thing when we're trying to do reverse shells. Okay, so I think that the issue is using WSL and I'm not sure how to solve it right now. So once that reverse shell should have worked, you need to look into the WP config file and there's some hard-coded credentials in there. So it's the same username again, but this time we're going to port 4512. Remember that was the port that was running SSH, and we're pasting the password that is hard-coded in that WP config file. So now that we're in, we can go ahead and grab our user.txt, and given those equals signs, that looks base64. So let's just pipe that through base64 decoded, and it looks like that is not English, but we're supposed to put it in as the encoded anyway, so that's cool. So next let's do some privilege escalation. Since we know the password that we found, we can go ahead and run that sudo -l to see what we can run with root privileges. So the first one that I see is vim, changemod and FTP. So I've done Vim before, so let's look at FTP. And we've got a FTP entry in GTFO bins, and it looks like a pretty simple shell that can be spawned with FTP. So let's run sudo FTP, paste in our password again, and then it's as simple as typing in our command to spawn a shell, and now we've got root access. So let's go home, or rather, let's go to the root directory, and let's cat out that root.txt. Paste that in, and we have done it. Awesome. So that was the TryHackMe Room Coldbox Easy. I hope you enjoyed this walkthrough. Apologize for being so much troubleshooting. I guess that's what I get for upgrading to Windows 11 and trying the Windows subset analytics. There's so many bugs in there that I've got to kind of figure out how to use. But anyway, lots to learn. That's always fun. Thanks for watching up until now. Like, subscribe, comment, do all that YouTube stuff. Up on the screen, you're going to see a recommended video picked out just for you. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you in the next video. All right, bye.